that minimized the impact to the neighboring businesses. As you were all aware yesterday, we had a large volume of fire, a rapidly spreading fire in high wind conditions that potentially could have damaged the neighboring properties on Middle Street and certainly those properties on India Street. And with their cooperation and the effort of the men and women of the Portland Fire Department, we were very fortunate to be able to keep this confined to the structure of origin. So at this time, I'd like to turn it over to Penny Littell, the planning director for the City of Portland.
Penny, could you tell us about the impact to local businesses?
Sure. We had about 14 restaurants or food service establishments that were impacted by the fire. We had our three inspectors out this morning doing an assessment and working with the business owners to identify goods that were potentially hazardous and needed to be destroyed. 10 of the businesses are back open. We have still two that we're following up on, and two we've just been unable to reach. So good news for the businesses. Most of them are back in business, and insurance companies have been on site, and we're working together to get everything back to normal.
Can you tell us which businesses remain closed?
Yes. The McCucci's Market and Benkei Restaurant are closed, as is Duck Fat, but we expect them to be open around 5 o'clock today.
Any damages?
There was no smoke damage that we identified, so that was good news. I think if you imagine the fire yesterday, we couldn't have had better conditions as far as wind is concerned, because it really went out to the bay.
I just have one follow-up question for Chief Lamontagne. Chief, you mentioned that this fire is likely happened during the demolition. What could have happened that sparked such a big fire? Did crews hit a gas line or an oil tank?
I think that, there's a long process that goes through with outlining a demolition plan. There's city ordinance, and there's certainly a demolition plan, perhaps, that Mark can speak to a little bit. But the reality is that using torches and cutting wheels, you know, certainly generates their spark. The crew took all the necessary precautions to minimize that exposure, and sometimes things just happen. This is an old building with a lot of design and renovation that has occurred over the years that create pockets for hidden fire, heat's generated. But we're not even sure that was conclusively it. It could have been something, completely unrelated to it. And that's what we'll never know. That's why we can't definitively say that the cause of the fire was the demolition efforts. We do know it was accidental. We have no reason to believe it's suspicious. The team of investigators have talked with most everybody involved, and we're very confident with our presumption.
And we've talked to a lot of people in business, neighboring businesses, who just are giving such a shout-out to the fire department for doing such a great job. Can you talk to that a little bit?
Absolutely. Yesterday was certainly not a typical fire in our experience. One of the things that, you know, we typically are dealing with is multifamily, single families home. In this particular incident, we had a complex operation with multiple exposures in the middle of the day with access issues and certainly crowd control issues. And water supply became a factor. The wind was a tremendous factor in all of this. And the training and the efforts of the men and women of the Portland Fire Department was outstanding. Yesterday, we had almost 100 Portland firefighters on scene. Probably 65 of those came off duty. Back to the call, they were here till midnight last night. And certainly, we were back here three or four times during the night and even twice this morning. So they did a great job.
Can you talk a little bit about the last time you saw a fire of this magnitude, especially in such a densely populated area?
In the last 26 years or so, these are certainly fires of significance. The one that makes this one most pronounced is the nature of the structure. It consumed an entire city block. We go back 15 years to Salem and Orange Street. Certainly, 10 years ago, we had the waste paper fire out off of Bishop Street. So in the city's history, this will certainly be listed as one of the more prominent instances we've had.
Do we know whereabouts in the structure it would have started, or is it too difficult to tell?
We have the initial area where fire was first seen, which is not indicative of where it started, and that's what makes this challenging, is in the middle portion of the building on the second floor. But that doesn't necessarily correlate to where the fire might have started. Do you want to speak a little bit to your efforts over
the
upcoming couple of weeks?
Sure.
Introduce.
Yeah. My name is Mark Waglum. I'm from Opeachy Construction. I'm also one of the principals in the property. I guess first and foremost, I'd like to thank the city and in particular the fire department for their efforts. Obviously, this could have been more catastrophic than it was. Happily, there were no injuries, and the fire department did an exceptional job of containing the fire, so we didn't have damage to adjacent properties. It's unfortunate from our perspective that this had to happen. From this stage forward, the best we can do is work with the city, and we've been working with them this morning to make sure that the ongoing demolitions, while now somewhat more complicated because of the structural issues related to the fire, we're going to make sure that we get this building, continue on with our demolition operations, continue on with the project. While this might amount to a setback that amounts to days because we're going to be a little slower in our demolition operations, the reality is we still intend to continue forward with the project as planned and working with the city to just make sure that the ongoing operations are conducted as safely and efficiently as possible. And that's how we intend to proceed from here.
So your timeline for this project is largely intact. It may just be a little bit more.
That's correct, yeah. We have to take the building down in a slower fashion than you might have if it were structurally intact.
I know that you guys were doing some salvage work. Is there a loss in terms of materials or resale, recycling those items?
No, we salvage the materials only in the sense that some items can go to recycling components. There wasn't anything of any significant value in the building. It does, again, complicate it because now some of the materials are intermixed, but there's really no financial loss other than the fact that we've got to do things a little more carefully going forward. Probably work some longer hours and pay some overtime, that sort of thing, to make sure that we stay on track time frame wise.
Can I just have you say and spell your name again, please?
Sure. My name is Mark Woglom, and the spelling is W-O-G-L-O-M. And the company is Opeche Construction, which is O-P-E-C-H-E-E.
And your title?
I'm the president.
Oh, great. Thank you, Mark.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for doing that.
You said at the beginning about this. Oops, hold on. Iris
sure.
Here. Wait 1 second here.
Yep.
It's a bright light.
During the overnight, Portland Fire Department crews remained on scene, putting out any hot spots and mitigating any areas that were starting to have flare-ups. This morning, we were able to meet with the representatives from Opeche Construction, President Mark Walgren, and Penny Littell, the Director of Planning for the city. We have outlined a course of action to continue the demolition of the building. We've assessed the structure in terms of its safety and stability, and we're confident that demolition can resume in a normal means. A little more complex, but certainly will continue as planned.
And you found you found the cause of the fire? Or?
That is correct. We're unable to determine the cause of the fire because of the amount of damage to the building and the subsequent destruction that had to be occurred to extinguish the fire, but we are confident that the fire was accidental in nature, was not suspicious, and potentially linked to the demolition activities that were occurring, but we will never be able to pinpoint the cause.
What happens with all the cleanup in the city here? I mean, all the stuff that went out in the Castro Bay and all the stuff on the streets?
The stuff in the streets, now that we have the roads open and the evening sets in, there'll be public services crews that'll be coming through and cleaning up the street. There was very little that went out into the bay, is my understanding. The stormwater area here goes down through the sewage treatment plant where it's filtered and purified. So there was no risk, or any time was Casco Bay at risk, to the best of my knowledge.
Okay, and so you think demolition will start next week or when?
We're actually hoping to have demolition start on Sunday. It's a question of how fast we can mobilize additional people and some of the technical expertise that needs to assess a plan for demolition to ensure that we maintain the safety of the individuals doing the demolition.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.